Ladies and gentlemen, from Tagbilaran City, Bohol, Philippines, the action continues here. Pinoy Pride 12, and it's all brought to you by Ala Promotions and ABS-CBN Sports. This next contest is scheduled for 8 rounds. It's in the junior welterweight division. Now let's meet the fighters. First of all, fighting out of the blue corner to my left, tonight wearing the white trunks with the blue. He weighed in at 139.5 pounds. Fight record, 10 wins, 7 losses, 9 victories by knockout. He comes to you from Jakarta, Indonesia, and he's known as the Hands of Stone. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a warm Bohol welcome to Frans Yarangga. And his opponent fighting out of the red corner to my right tonight, wearing the red trunks with the Philippine flag. He weighed in at 140.5 pounds, fight record, 27 wins, 2 losses, with 16 knockouts. Originally from Cagayan de Oro City, now fighting out of Cebu City, here is Jason El Nino Pagara.
Momentum going in.
And yes, and that's not very long ago, so let's see what he brings to the ring tonight against Jason Pagara, very promising young fighter.
Scheduled for 8 rounds, Pagara, the reigning WBO Asia Pacific Youth Light Welterweight Champion, which he won by a second round knockout.
Filippo Pagara will use the jab to set up the right hand. He has a height and reach advantage.
Yes, and the Yarangga is keeping his distance.
Tama. I don't think he wants to come and mix it up with Jason Pagara. Sinabi na naman at the press conference, we'll feel this guy out first and see what happens. But he might not have time to see what happens.
Oh, no. Bouncing off the ropes from the early display of power by Pagara.
Jason Pagara is at 140 pounds. That's a junior welterweight division. That's where Timothy Bradley and the guys fight. So, you know, Yarangga.
Wild
left and right, hoping for the best.
Well, he's going to lose a lot of energy that way. He's now very focused. He's a little reckless in the early part of his career.
He's technically a very good fighter, see Jason Pagara.
Well, they got him really early. Started fighting at the age of 14, 6 years ago. That was September 24, his first fight as a pro.
See, you can see that Pagara is using the left to set up the right. Mm-hmm. And Yarangga is going for that wild roundhouse right and left.
He's hoping for a haymaker.
Hoping for a haymaker, yeah. Jason, more precise, Pagara.
And you know, Jason, called El Nino, he wears some of the glitter which is reminiscent of the robes that people dress the Santo Nino with. Of course, Santo Nino, very dear to the hearts of our countrymen in Cebu.
And
great setup with the jab, Ronnie. He caught him
exactly
what
he said. He's going to throw the left, set him up, and crack him with the right.
And you know, he was flat footed, so he also lost his balance there.
Okay, early knockdown in round number one, and Pagara setting the tone of this fight.
Oh boy. I think Yarangga realizes he's in trouble. There's no change in his facial expression, though. And he's really fighting flat footed here, he's not dancing around.
Because he's going for that big right.
And he's very predictable.
Predictable, really.
He'll step in, then lean forward, and throw the wild right.
Missed again with a wild uppercut.
He's going to wear himself out. Pagara taking his time. That's a good sign.
Yes.
He's not rushing into a finish the job.
He's mature now.
Yes. And, you know, Yarangga is lunging, which is not a good sign in very poor form.
I say he'll get caught with the counter while he lunges and he's gone.
He's wasting a lot of energy doing that.
Final seconds of round number one. Good round for Jason Pagara.
Yes, that's the end of the round.
Time now for the Cobra Tulane and Akash clinch of the round.
hook there, but you're right, Ronnie. The left jab caught him ducking, and he got yes. caught.
Tamaka, he was a little off balance too.
Yes.
You know.
But he was squared.
He was squared, Tamaka.
Okay, round number two. But still, that counts as a knockdown, so it's a...
Kenny Brown.
Good start by Jason Pagara. They touch gloves to start the second round, scheduled for eight, but all of a sudden, Yarangga's time is ticking away. But Jason Pagara, throughout his young career, has gone from strength to strength to strength.
Yes, he's potentially a very good fighter. His only problem is pretty heavy, so at 140 pounds, I'm going to have international competition.
That's going to be tough.
Grabe.
Because you're no longer fighting the Mexicans and the Latino fighters. You're going to start fighting some of the African-American fighters as well. And perhaps some Europeans too. Those are the big hitters already.
Pagara.
But Pagara still, he's got plenty of time.
Yes, he's a young kid. Yeah,
very young.
Oh. That Yarangga's right miss.
Telegraphed completely, you know. Pagara dancing a little bit, trying to throw him off his rhythm. And he's not even looking when he throws.
Yes. Oh, right straight. I think this may be the end.
He tried to fake Jason out, and Jason said, this is not fake. This is real.
Right straight. Oh, he is knocked down again. He's ready to go, right?
Tries to smile it off, but oh boy.
And he's only got that one weapon that's been misfiring.
And the problem is, because of the aluminum reach advantage, Jason, he cannot come close enough.
Come on, he's going to get
almost going again. Almost going again.
I think this is it.
Yeah.
Got clocked twice with the right. Oh, he was taking his time. He's wobbly.
He's wobbly but ready.
Trying to shake it off. Takes the standing eight count. And Pagara has enough time to finish him off.
Yeah.
Plenty of time. And Pagara in no hurry. He's in total command.
You don't go see Jason Pagara. He's waiting for his moments. He's waiting for the opportunity. And this guy.
And he doesn't cover. He leaves himself open.
Pagara biding his time, waiting to drop the bomb.
Yarangga
with that one weapon.
The roundhouse right. If he catches Jason with that, then it could be a different story.
Yes.
But he's been missing all the time.
1-2 combination, and Pagara stepping in.
And the thing is, when he threw the right, Pagara stepped back and covered up very nicely. Another right, grazing right hand by Jason Pagara.
And Pagara mixing it up here, and it's confusing Yarangga. Sabi ni Yarangga, hands of stone daw siya, pero matigas lang ang mukha niya.
Totoo yan. A head, clash of heads. Jason was worried there, yes. Told the referee, but the fight will continue.
Now he's, Yarangga is trying to buy some time. He's got a cut on the top of his head.
Oh, that's a terrible cut. That's a terrible cut. And you know, if they stop the fight, I don't know what they're going to do.
Because it's not midway through the fight.
Then. Yeah, it's an eight-round fight. Normally, you have to complete four rounds. But since this is an eight-round fight, they may go to the scorecard since it's third round. I'm not quite sure of how that rule operates.
I don't think this cut is going to be enough to stop the fight.
Yeah.
It just hurts like hell.
Dr. Unabia is taking a good close look at that.
At best, he's buying himself some time.
Yeah.
Fight.
It says fight. Oh, boy.
That's good.
Do I have to?
Well,
that's what he came here for. Now he's complaining of the pain.
The doctor says fight.
The doctor can't give you anything for that.
Now, if he doesn't fight, then it's a TKO.
The automatic.
Automatic TKO.
And this guy has knocked out 58% of his opponents.
Well, they must have gotten caught. That's a, you know, clubbing right hand.
Yes.
And alam mo na yung cut on the forehead, it bleeds a lot, but it's not dangerous.
There aren't really any nerve endings in the forehead. Of course, there's no muscle to protect your head either. Pagara trying to finish him before the round ends.
Stunning left by Pagara.
Down again. He's gone this time, I think. Gets up again.
Oh boy, and the crowd applauding. And you know, it's just a couple of seconds before the end of the round, so he's gonna...
He's gonna survive.
He's gonna survive, but... So I don't understand. Are they... Stop, the round's not over yet.
Ah, Willy Lasut. Ah, he's talking to referee Peregrino. It's over.
It's over. The fight's over.
The fight. The corner man stopped it. That's my impression.
Preventing him from taking any more punishment. Let's check out our Cobra Punch.
Time now for the Cobra Tulane and Lacoste Punch of the Round.
Great job here by Jason Pagara. And after the first round, he was... Oh!
Maganda yung kanan niya. Dire-direcho. Right. Flash on the face.
Yeah. Turned his head. And he really didn't have anything left.
Look, another beautiful right by
that combination
Pagara.
Wobbled him. Then another right to the temple just threw him off balance. And, you know, this was a demolition job.
Yeah.
From the opening minute.
He was dropped three times in the second round. But give the guy credit, he got up.
Oh, yeah, and kept on going and going and going. And his corner said, enough, enough, enough.
Come on.
They'll have a couple of bouts coming up, including a main event. A game but overmatched. Frans Yarangga of Indonesia.
The Indonesian champion suffers a third round TKO.
Yes, the hands of stone bites the dust. Let's get the official time.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Delbert Pellegrino waves off the bout due to the three knockdown rule. The time, 2:41 of the second round, and the winner by TKO, now 28-2, Jason Pagara!